Hello. Today, under the unit Emerging Infectious Diseases and Antimicrobial Resistance, we are going to study the emerging infectious diseases, which will have the following learning objectives. You will learn what is emergence and re-emergence of the disease, what are the various categories of the emerging diseases, history of emergence and re-emergence of diseases in the last century across the world and in India, and the WHO action plan to mitigate the emergence or re-emergence of the diseases. Let us first start with a few definitions. An emerging infectious disease is one that has appeared and affected a population for the first time, or it has existed previously but is rapidly increasing, either in terms of the number of new cases within a population or in its spread to new geographical areas. Now, what is re-emerging diseases? It is also grouped under the emerging infectious diseases, but these are those that have affected a given area in the past, has declined or were controlled, but they are again being reported in increasing numbers and appearing in new clinical forms that may be severe or fatal. We normally categorize emerging infectious diseases into five broad categories. The first is the newly emerging infectious diseases, where the diseases are recognized in humans for the first time. For example, the HIV AIDS, which started from recognition from 1981, the Nipah virus, the SARS, the MERS, even the present COVID-19. The re-emerging infectious diseases are those that have historically infected humans, but continue to reappear either in new locations, as I said earlier, or in new forms. For example, the West Nile virus in the United States and in Russia in 1999, or the resistant forms of Staph aureus, which is methicillin resistant. Sometimes diseases are emerging as a result of deliberate release. These are associated with mass bioterrorism. We do not have many examples, but there had been cases particularly with anthrax, which I will come to later. There might be accidental emerging of infectious diseases. These are diseases that are created by humans that are released unintentionally. For example, the epizoonotic vaccinia and transmissible vaccine derived polioviruses. De-emerging diseases, these are those that have been eliminated or even eradicated, or are in the process of elimination and or eradication. Smallpox is an example, which has been eradicated in 1980, and the Rinderpest veterinary disease in 2021. This list gives you a number of diseases and the emergence and re-emergence of various infections since 1973. So, we start with rotavirus emergence in 1973, then we had the Ebola virus in 1977, the Hunter virus again in 1977. Like that, we have a list of several different diseases that have come up in the last few decades since 1973. If we look at the timeline of the 21st century outbreaks and vector reservoirs, then we will see that in 2003, the SARS coronavirus, the first one, appeared, and then subsequently in 2003 in India, the 2005 in India, the chikungunya virus appeared. The Rift Valley fever in East Africa appeared in 2007. The H1N1 swine flu occurred worldwide since 2009. Then the chikungunya virus again affected the Americas in 2014, yellow fever came in America in 2016, Nipah virus in India in 2018, and then the SARS coronavirus, coronavirus 2, that came in 2019, end of 19 and 2020. In between, there had been dengue outbreaks in Americas in 2002, in 2010, and in 2020 also. Like that, there had been several outbreaks across the world, and various reservoir hosts have been identified for most of them. If we look at the global map of significant and new emerging infections in humans, which has spread to new areas since 1998, in this particular photograph or this graph, you can see the green ones are those which are newly identified emerging infections, and the brown ones are those diseases that are spread to new areas, whereas the blue ones are those which are emerging infections as well as spread to newer areas. So, there are several diseases listed here which can be seen. It has almost spanned in the entire world. This figure shows the newly emerging diseases in red color, the re-emerging or resurging diseases in blue color, and a deliberately emerging disease in dark blue color. If you can see, there is only one in the deliberately emerging disease, which is in North America, which has been given here as the anthrax for bioterrorism. If you remember, it came in newspaper envelopes in letter forms, the spores, and then it was identified as a potential agent of bioterrorism. This is a timeline of new and emerging infections since 1998, along with the reservoirs that have been responsible for their spread, as well as the vectors that are involved. Again, it is a very complicated and a busy slide, and this gives a timeline of how new and emerging infections have affected the world since 1998. This slide gives those of the emerging and re-emerging viral diseases. As you can see, on the extreme left, we have the dengue, followed by the West Nile virus, then the first SARS virus, and these also have the reported fatality rates written against each of them, and they have been quite variable for various diseases. And as you can see, the beginning from dengue to the present COVID-19, there are a number of diseases that have been listed, including the Marburg virus, the chikungunya, swine flu, MERS, Ebola, Zika, and yellow fever. The WHO Research and Development Blueprint for Action to Prevent Epidemics actually followed after the Ebola outbreak in 2014. It was made on the request of 194 member states in May 2015. The WHO convened a broad network of experts to develop a blueprint for research and development. The experts compiled an initial list of diseases and the general approach and key prioritization areas. The criteria was formulated by December 2015. Now, how did WHO prioritize these diseases? They have done it by an exercise first, where all the diseases and pathogens were listed. A landscape analysis was done, a Delphi process was done, taking opinions from various experts and stakeholders. Then a triaging was done with the list of these diseases to be considered, and from that the list of contenders for prioritization, which was a long list, was made. It was on ranking of diseases by an algorithm, and then assessing confidence in the prioritized list, reviewing the results again through Delphi process, and then the ranking of the long list of diseases and pathogens according to their priority, and then the final list was made, the prioritized list of diseases and pathogens, for promoting the prioritized list, and post prioritization activities were started. So, this is what the WHO had done. The WHO 2018 list of diseases to be prioritized under the R&D blueprint. Now, a point to note here is that there are other agencies also which have actually made this prioritized list, like the Coalition for Epidemic Preparedness Innovations, which is given in orange in this particular slide in an orange circle. Similarly, that of the UK Vaccine Research and Development Network is given in purple here on the right side, and then the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Disease made a priority list which is given in the green, and it was made in 2016. As you can see, there is a amount of overlap between the diseases that have been prioritized by all these agencies, and as you can see that disease X also is included here, which is basically a placeholder. So, to make the countries ready for eventuality of a particular disease that suits that placeholder criteria. So, so that is how the countries have been have tried to prepare themselves for emerging or controlling emerging infectious diseases. As we have seen that most of the prioritized conditions are for viral infections, but then there are bacterial infections also which are in priority list. Particularly, it arises out of the emergence of antimicrobial resistance. So, in the priority one, the critical ones that have been chosen are Acinetobacter baumannii, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, Enterobacteriaceae. So, these are mostly resistant to carbapenems, and the Enterobacteriaceae is also resistant to the third generation cephalosporins. Then in the high priority comes the Enterococcus, Staphylococcus, Helicobacter, Campylobacter, Salmonella species and Neisseria. So, and in medium we have the Streptococcus pneumoniae, Haemophilus influenza and Shigella species. Now, we come back to our Indian scenario, and as you can see here, the map shows the various recognized sites of emergence and re-emergence of infections since 1990. And as you can see that in the spot map, diphtheria in Delhi in 2000, Chandipura in Gujarat in 2004, in Andhra in 2003, and you have say H1N1 in Hyderabad in 2009, in Surat you have CGHF in 2011, Chandipura again in Maharashtra in 2007. The Nipah in Siliguri in 2001, then we had the plague in Uttarakhand in 2004 and in Shimla in 2002. So, if the Indian review is taken, then the emerging infectious diseases that are prioritized under the WHO R&D blueprint that I just talked about, then this is what the map would look like, and the states are given in different colors. And the vulnerability of these areas as far as these diseases are concerned following the WHO R&D blueprint is shown in this checkered boxes on the right of the screen. So, this is the emerging infectious diseases in chronological succession in India, again taken from the year 2000. I just showed them on the spot map on the Indian map. Here it is through the timelines, and this slide shows the known threats of emerging viral infections in the country, where we have the MERS-CoV, which is airborne, and it has got extremely high outbreak potential. Then Ebola virus, which is through direct contact with outbreak potential, avian influenza, you have various kinds of avian influenza, then the yellow fever, then we have various other diseases that have been listed here, and some of the outbreak potential is unknown, and even the biosafety risk group also in some of the diseases that are listed at the bottom are also unknown. So, in summary, emerging diseases are a threat to humankind, and emerging diseases can be deliberate or even accidental, and human and animal interactions are the lead responsible causes for emergence of infectious diseases, and most of these emergent diseases are of viral nature. And WHO has framed the R&D blueprint for pandemic control, and it annually prioritizes the list of the emerging infectious diseases, and these are being done again in country also depending on their vulnerability and their priorities. These are some of the references which you would like to read and learn more about these topics that I talked about.